A reoccurring theme for my What the Hell Is This videos has been strange animals from the Permian and Triassic, and the patrons have done it again, voting this time for Ozimek volans, which together with its relative Charovipteryx, my wife affectionately calls butt wings, and that's because they had butt wings, or at least wings that came off of the rear legs, and this leads to Ozimek's scientific name being volans, because that just means volant, it could fly, or at least glide. Superficially, Ozimek may remind you of the pterosaurs, which were evolving around the same time, also had long limbs, and had a membrane on which they flew, although Ozimek, like I mentioned earlier, probably only glided. And while the earlier found Charovipteryx wasn't actually preserved with front limbs, we do have the front limbs in Ozimek, and they help to show the proportions of the animals like Ozimek weren't actually quite that similar to the pterosaurs, and so they were doing something a bit different in their flying and gliding style. And actually, there have been some aerodynamic studies to look at animals like Charovipteryx and Ozimek to try and understand what they would have looked like in life, because on Charovipteryx, which is the only one of these animals that we actually have a membrane for, it's missing those front limbs, so it's really hard to say what was going on up there. And what the researchers on that paper found is that it probably did have an extra set of membranes on the upper limbs, and so this would have just helped them be able to glide and maneuver around their forested environment a little bit easier. But with Ozimek, we can see just how different the limb proportions were to those of the pterosaurs, because pterosaurs had very, very long front limbs, and Ozimek had longer back limbs. And so this means that it's probably not actually that closely related to the pterosaurs. There was just a lot of niche space opening up for different animals like Ozimek and the pterosaurs to try and start entering the skies, at least in short glides, and then eventually flight with the pterosaurs. And this gliding behavior actually isn't that strange in the reptiles. There's a few different groups that have evolved the ability to glide throughout the fossil record. These include things like the Wiggletosaurids, which actually lived in the Permian, so they're definitely not related to Ozimek. They're just too early to be related to it. However, there was the Drepanosaurus, which really we do have good fossils of from the Triassic, and some of them have been suggested to potentially been gliders. And it's still really hard to prove, and some of them are also shown not to be gliders because they were fossorial, meaning they dug under the ground and lived in burrows. So the Drepanosaurs were their own weird group of animals that also glided, but were still doing things a bit more differently, especially with their arm bones, than animals like Ozimek. In fact, if you look at the hand morphology of one of the more arboreal and tree-climbing species of Drepanosaurs, you'll see that its arm and wrist morphology is entirely different from any other animal. It still has all the same bones, they're just pushed and misshapen compared to everything else. And this worked out for this animal, it was moderately successful, but it also helps to show that Ozimek is not related to the Drepanosaurs. So this just means that Ozimek and its relative Charovipteryx probably evolved flight entirely independently, or at least gliding entirely independently, of any other reptile that was around during the Triassic. And that means we need to start looking towards other features to try and understand what it was related to. For example, its long neck. It was a very necky animal. And there were actually a couple different groups that were evolving long necks during the same time in the Triassic. And the first of these is the dinosaurs. And you may just be thinking about things like the sauropods, which famously have very long necks, but even other dinosaurs still have pretty long necks. I mean, you can look at things like Allosaurus skeletons, and when you actually look at it in detail, you go, oh no, that thing does have a decent neck. However, it wasn't one of these. And there's a couple different reasons that we can tell that it wasn't a dinosaur. One of the main features that shows Ozimek was not a dinosaur is the fourth trochanter, which is a flange of bone that is just a little bit more pointed in dinosaurs. And it sounds like a very specific feature, but there's a number of these that all go into defining different groups, including the dinosaurs. In fact, if we zoom out from Dinosauria to look at the overall group that it comes from, the archosaurs, what we can see is Ozimek isn't even one of those. Now, the archosaurs include things like crocodilians and the dinosaurs, and one of the most distinctive features about them is that they had a more upright posture. This is the same kind of thing you see when alligators do their high walk today, but then also the dinosaurs, which had their very upright posture. And Ozimek had a much more sprawling posture. It did not have the hip adaptations to achieve this more upright position. So while Ozimek was not technically an archosaur, it was actually still probably pretty close. And a lot of that is based on the group that it is found to be most closely related to, at least most of the time it's found to be most closely related to this group. And that's the Tanystropheids. The Tanystropheids are famous for having wildly, wildly long necks, even longer proportionally than many sauropods. And they were mostly aquatic from what we know. It's very likely that they essentially would just punt or run across the bottom of the seafloor and use that long neck to approach schools of fish or squid while they were hunting. What this means is that there was probably an ancestor to the Tanystropheids and the animals like Ozimek, and it probably spent a lot of time near the trees and near the water. And some of the animals took to the water more, and some of them took to the trees more. And the ones that took to the water just developed an even longer neck so that they could try and specialize in hunting these more slippery prey. But then the ones in the trees, they evolved a membrane. And genetically, this would make sense. It's literally just a single random mutation that adds a little fold of skin to the back of the animal's legs. And then when it's jumping from branch to branch, it can jump a little bit further than other ones. And then this continues over millions of years until you get the very strange butt wings of animals like Ozimek. But there's still debate about this. And a large part of that comes from the fact that we really only have these two different species of animals like Ozimek and Charoviptrix. Those two species being Ozimek and Charoviptrix. So it's really hard to try and get a better idea of what the animals may have been related to when we have such a small sample size. I mean, if we're only comparing two animals of what was potentially a much more broad and diverse group, including some of the more ancestral animals in that group, if we had those, we could probably get a better idea of what specifically it was. But based on just the two different animals that we have right now, it does seem most likely and most reasonable to try and say that they're closely related to the Tanystropheids, and potentially even the sister group to it, meaning that they just had that very recent common ancestor to when these two groups evolved and did very different and very specialized things. Hey everyone, thanks for watching. If you join the Patreon, you can actually vote for the What the Hell Are These videos. They've been a lot of fun to do and see what people pick when the options come up. This is one of those interesting groups where it's really hard to actually say definitively what it is simply because we have such poor numbers of them. So, you know, hopefully people will get out and find some more. Everyone just remember, be safe, take care, and don't go extinct.